All right, I am the ultimate Tim. That was the penultimate Tim before. So let's talk about fly fishing. Yeah, stand in the water wearing rubber pants. Throwing a little piece of fuzz in the water hoping to catch a dangerous predator, but you know what's going to happen is not all the water is that calm. Most of it looks like that, and you know what they are? Bears. Oh yeah, Tim was right, the other Tim. What's going to happen is you're going to hook your finger, not the fish, then you're going to fall in the water and fill your rubber pants with water, and while you're laying there vulnerable, the bears will come for you. I guarantee it. Playing guitar is our next hobby. There's only one reason to play guitar, and that is to get girls, as you can see there, whether it be a whole horde or just one on the beach or your favorite lady. But I got to tell you, there's a huge danger with guitar, and that is it takes a whole lot of practice to get good at guitar. So your lady's probably going to look more like that most of the time. Your fingers will end up looking like that, as Brian Adams warned us in summer of 69. And a heavy, heavy guitar is going to hurt your back. The biggest danger with guitar, of course, though, is you can never have one guitar. Drums is the next hobby that you should pick up after you do guitar. I mean, why do air drums like Mike Tyson when you can do the real thing? Play drums, beat the heck out of them. It's good exercise. It gives you good blood flow. It helps improve your rhythm, which your lady might enjoy as soon as you actually develop better rhythm by practicing, which it also takes a bunch. Drumming is also important in the carpal tunnel development. So if you're a computer programmer like most of you and spend your day typing, drumming's not going to help your carpal tunnel. Plus, in the back, you're going to get attention starved and be like crazy drummer guy. Once you've got that all figured out, it's time to record yourself. You can make songs by building up your drums and guitar and produce an entire band yourself or collaborate with people on the internet. It's a lot of fun. The problem with recording, though, is you're going to hear yourself. And you sound really bad most of the time, I guarantee it. There's also this problem where you're going to get tempted to fix all your little mistakes in that magical software there, since you're probably a software guy, instead of actually trying to get better, which is probably a little more wise. Scooters is our next hobby. Scooters are a lot of fun, yeah? Scooters are fun. You get 50 miles a gallon. You can park on the sidewalk, which is a lot of fun. Scooter culture also attracts a lot of interesting ladies, although most of them have a lot more tattoos than that one. The problem with scooters, though, is they do break down a lot since it's so tempting to monkey with their engines and make them go faster so you feel a little bit more manly on them. Especially on East Colfax at 2 in the morning, they tend to break down right about then. Also, drivers have a really hard time seeing scooters, so you'll probably end up crashed if you're not careful. Burned your brain at both ends all day doing computer programming? Why not work with your hands and do some woodworking? You can build some fine furniture or just do something more useful, like build a trebuchet that shoots tennis balls. All right, so now that you've got that going, there's a problem. If you've burned your brain at both ends all day, the worst possible thing you could do is use power tools. I guarantee you there is no hobby that is more likely to cause you to lose a limb than using a saw all day. Not enough room in your garage for all those power tools? Why not do some electrical wiring to wire that up so you can hook up more stuff to cut your fingers off? It's actually surprisingly fun to wire your own house once you learn all the different rules. And guess what happens if you don't learn all those rules? Yes, fire, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, electrocution is a lot less likely than fire. Oh, and also those electrical boxes are very sharp and you will likely cut yourself. Fire is no fun for anyone.
Bring it home, Tim!
I'm working! Robots! All right, robots are our next exciting hobby. They're a great way to introduce your kids to computer programming since it brings the virtual to the real. Robots come in all kinds of shapes and sizes. Robot satellites, cars that drive themselves. There's actually no downsides to making robots.
Amen!
Or so I'm told. The next hobby is tabletop games. If you're tired of playing computer games with people you can't see, can't touch, can't get to know, go sit down at a table and actually play some games with people that you can actually get to know. You might even meet a nice girl and get custom dice made with your name on them there. There is a huge downside to gaming. You can get paper cuts on your eyeball. Also, those little four-sided dice are known as the caltrops of the gaming world. You will end up stepping on them or have your lovely girl step on them, which is no fun for anyone. Our last hobby is home brewing. Make your own beer at home. It is incredibly great to make beer that you actually like instead of settling for the swill that someone else gives you. That is some lovely roasted barley in the corner and my little homebrew set up there. It's quite easy to do. quite easy to make your own beer. The main disadvantage and danger of homebrewing is it's extremely traditional while homebrewing to drink homebrew while making homebrew, especially in large quantities. Also, those huge glass bottles you saw are very heavy and you're carrying them around wet and drunk. You have a very good chance of hurting yourself. So, I'm Tim White. Thanks for enjoying all of my hobbies.